We can find the molecular geometry for SO2 in two ways. First, we can use the Lewis structure for SO2 to visualize how the atoms and unbonded electron pairs will spread out in three dimensions. This is because electrons are negative and they repel each other. The Lewis structure doesn't tell us this directly, but if we visualize the atoms and unbonded electron pairs on that central atom repelling each other, we'll see that the oxygen atoms move away from the unbonded pair and give the molecule a bent shape. That looks like this. In essence, the valence shell electron pairs are repelling each other, giving SO2 its shape. We can also use the AXN notation to determine the shape of SO2. A is the central atom, the sulfur. We have one of those. X, the bonded atoms, those two oxygen atoms. And N, that is the unbonded electron pairs. We only have one unbonded electron pair for SO2. We'll ignore the ones, and we can see that we have AX2N. We can remember that this is a bent molecule, or we can look it up on a table. Here we can see AX2N is bent and has a bond angle of 120 degrees. That bond angle looks like this. And that's it, the SO2 molecular geometry. It's bent at the bond angle of 120 degrees. This is Dr. B, and thanks for watching.